The only question we need to ask right now is which watch will Rolex discontinue and which one should you buy right now? And I have gathered all the informations from the famous influencers in the world of watches in one video. So stay tuned and let's see what are their opinions. It's the time of the year. We need to check which watch gets probably discontinued. And I have some options with me right now and we will directly start because there are a lot. So first of all, we directly start with one famous channel, Bark and Jack, and they have some very interesting opinions. First of all, here's a picture of the Explorer with a white dial. In the past, we always had a black dial. Right now, they suggest maybe Rolex is going to release a white one. This is not so interesting like the next watch I will show you from them. The 70th anniversary of the Submariner is this year, and therefore, they think Rolex might release a platinum Submariner. This was never the case that we had a Submariner in this precious metal, but maybe they are going to release it. And obviously, if platinum is used by Rolex, it will have this ice blue color. It would be an awesome watch, platinum one. I always like the white gold, the Smurf. I mean, it's not selling that well, but overall it has a nice look to it. Then everyone is checking for Daytona models. That's why we probably see some changes in the collection. And I will give you also some advice. Maybe you can use it, which watch you should buy right now, which gets discontinued probably. Here we have a 60th anniversary platinum Daytona with a green dial. It could be possible. We saw the version in the platinum day date that they released a green one. Also the Arabic day date in green is in platinum available. So maybe there is a chance. I don't think that they are going to release one with a green dial, a Daytona in platinum, but who knows. Then we have another channel, Trendy Tickers from London, and they are thinking that there will be some changes also for the Daytona series. First off, some new dials, and I'm thinking it's most likely that Rolex is going to release some new dials. They have here one in white gold or platinum with a green dial, so they just copied the John Mayer onto a white gold version. I don't think so that this is going to happen because Rolex released the John Mayer in yellow gold with a green dial and in blue at the same time in the white gold version, so this is the pair, and I don't think that they will just, you know, flip it to the other side. It looks nice though, but yeah, let's see. Then Trendy Tickers also released some great overview. Here we have a platinum Skydweller. Skydweller, there could be a chance that they are going to release a watch. It looks awesome here with this ice blue dial. This would be the heaviest watch from Rolex. Let's see. Then here's a suggestion from one user called Angelo 073. I heard the rumors that some people say, yeah, maybe this time Rolex is going to use something from Tudor. Yeah, so Tudor is available, the black bay with the red bezel. I don't think that this would ever be the case that Rolex is going to put a red bezel on a Submariner, but yeah, who knows, you never know. This one is more likely possible. Here we see a Coke bezel on a GMT Master. Rolex always repeats from the past. This is a model a lot of people are asking for it. It would also be nice to see this one maybe in a precious metal. Coke version, I would say it could be the case. Then here is one on the Jubilee bracelet, obviously, yes. Then Vintage London Watches Rolex. They released also a couple of watches. Here we see also a precious metal platinum Submariner. So a lot of people are betting on this one. And we see an updated yellow gold Daytona with a green ceramic bezel. I don't think they will do some fancy stuff like this in a colorful bezel, but overall it's time to change the metal bezel to a full ceramic bezel. So overall, in all Daytona models, you won't see a metal bezel. This, I think, would be a great choice. Also, it's more advanced. You know, the metal bezel always gets scratched. Ceramic is the better option, so this is something possible. Then we have here the man behind the crown. He went full daredevil. Here we have a full red Submariner. So also the dial is in red and the bezel is also in red. If Rolex will produce something like this, they would never do. They would never do it. Then from the watch lovers from Amsterdam, they made a full black GMT Master with a Jubilee bracelet. Would be nice. The old model 11610 Lunette Noire is highly popular. It looks great on the Jubilee bracelet, but I don't think they will reintroduce. If they do, it would be not the best thing for the discontinued model. So probably the price will stay the same. And the longer a color is discontinued, in this case, a full black bezel, it's good. So if you you have the old GMT, they will not produce a new one, then it's great for you. If they reintroduce it, it's not so good. Then steel and gold with the green bezel Submariner.
Yeah, I mean, it's possible, but the green color always stayed in the past with the full steel model, so I think it will be here the same.
This post is from Luxury Watch Media. Then here, Rolex prediction, trendy tickers also went full red on a GMT Master. In the past, it was never the case. I mean, we had in the beginning the blueberry, but right now, I don't think it's going too far. What is this? Here we have the man behind the crown with another hit. A Sky Dweller in yellow gold with the green dial. Looks awesome. The green is maybe a little bit too intensive, but it's a nice pick. And he also released one Platinum Submariner. So yeah, the consumers, the crowd is asking for a precious metal Submariner in platinum. Let's see. Yeah, let's see if they are going to release it. It has the same color combination like the Daytona. If they are going to release one Submariner, I don't think they will just copy the concept from the Platinum Daytona to a Submariner. They will probably do something new, obviously with the color ice blue. Then here we see something which is highly possible. GMG Watches UK showed us Daytona in rose gold with a ceramic bezel, full rose gold with a ceramic bezel. This one looks awesome. Rolex should introduce it and it looks great. Rolex prediction. The Instagram account has here white gold, blue dial and blue bezel Daytona. Colorful bezels, I don't think they will do it, but it's possible that they are going to release it with the black bezel. Then we have here Bark and Jack again with a titanium 70th anniversary Submariner with the red writing. I mean, it's the anniversary and Rolex always introduces something from the past. If they are going to do that, if they are going to release this model, then they will probably discontinue the Sea Dweller Red. You know, this, if they produce it for the same time, it wouldn't make that sense. But in titanium, boy, it would be awesome. If I love to see another watch in titanium. We just have the Deep Sea Challenge. Then as a next stop from TikTok, there are two versions of a white gold Daytona. It can be also steel with a green dial, green bezel. Okay, blue Submariner, probably white gold with the red writing. Yeah, maybe, I mean. And a full gold, I mean, this looks awesome. This is the Rolex Explorer. This is 36 millimeter in size and it's available in steel and gold. And here it's a full gold version. Not very popular, but I think this really looks awesome in full gold. Let's continue. Look at this. This is the Tridor. So you have three different metals. You have white gold, rose gold, and yellow gold in the center link. And it's an old reference from the 90s, beginning of early 20. And this is a watch, a day date. Not very popular if they are going to reintroduce it. I mean, this would be really something. And then the thing everyone is talking about, Daytona in steel. On the left side, we have the current model, white and black. And on the right side, there's an updated model. This one is from Rolex Passion Report. And in the past, they always had some very interesting informations before everyone else. And I don't know. I mean, it has been 7 years for the ceramic Daytona. Mondani is always talking about that this watch will get discontinued. I mean, the steel Daytona, if they are going to reintroduce this model and will change it, the prices will probably jump for at least 10 to 15% overnight minimum, because the Daytona is always the most sought after. Also in the times where the prices has dropped, the Daytona stays the Daytona. Yeah, especially the one in white, highly collectible, and everyone wants this watch. And the prices increased from January until now by around, let's say 10%, not really 9%, 8 to 9%, the prices increased. So you should keep an eye definitely on a just regular steel Daytona ceramic bezel. If they are going to discontinue it, it will be a highly collectible. But let me tell you one thing. We just talked about all these possible things. At the end, no one knows. Yeah, Watches and Wonders will be at the end of this month, and then we are going to see some interesting things, and we are all looking forward. Buy the watches you like, and if the price go up, you are happy. If the price stay the same, it's also good. And if the price go down, there's no need to kill yourself. Overall, if you take a look at the long chart, let's say around 10 years, all perform very well. So just stay calm, buy what you like, and watches are always a great investment in case you have a time frame which is not 1 year. So yeah, this is it for me. Leave a like and subscribe to this channel, and then I see you guys next time. Bye bye.